Oteka were one of the few bands that we signed on Warp just from a demo tape. They phoned up before they sent the tape in, and we just heard, thought it was amazing when we heard it in the office. We used to play it all the time and dance around the office. Sometimes we'd do headstands. This is why Oteka music is so good. It's just really good headstand music.
The first two tracks that we liked the most went on the Artificial Intelligence album, and Crystal and Yeg. And then for a period of like nearly 2 years, we just kept in fairly close contact, playing the music. Not necessarily with like a view to like getting a deal or anything. We just wanted to know what they thought, and they sort of approached us and said, we're going to do, well, we feel like doing an Oteka album.
They're almost like scientists of sound or sonic sculptors. You know, they take every single sound. Every single sound is so perfectly formed and so thought out that it's there's nothing in their music that you could add or take away. Everything's been thought out to the absolute final degree, and they've got a very, very strict sense of what is and what isn't their music, and they don't allow anything through that's not up to their quality control.
I mean, people think that Oteka's music is weird or abstract or left field, but compared to the music they listen to, like Todd Dockstader or Stockhausen or Steve Reich, as far as they're concerned, they're doing pop music.
Mark Bell, Mark Clifford, Jimmy Tennant. I mean, we're going to start going through the whole list now.
Yeah.
When you start thinking of the artists in question, and not necessarily the albums they're putting out or the presentation from album to album. I mean, we tend to just present ourselves like this, you know, just us, as opposed to like a style or a look or an image.
Yeah.
And like, when we break people down into that category, you've got Mark Bell, Mark Clifford, Jimmy Tennant, Richard, Tom, Mira Kalix, and like, no. Old Nightmares. I mean, Warp's got seriously hardcore back catalogue of amazing music. And I think it's always hard to spot at the time of release how classic that is going to be in time, in the future.
Like Oteka, and perhaps quite a few of the artists on the label, is that these aren't guys who spend their teenage years in front of the mirror in the bedroom practicing with a microphone or a tennis racket instead of a guitar. They're interested in music purely and simply for music's sake. They don't want to be pop stars, they don't want to be doing interviews, they don't want to be doing television. They want to make music, and having to do the press rounds is part of the job. They have to do it, but it's not a part that they welcome, it's not a part they dream about.
Well, music's it's like a therapy for them. If they're not in the studio making music 8 hours a day, they literally go mad. They've got voices inside their head giving them that music. They can't not be making music.
Yeah, I mean, you notice with people like Oteka or Aphex or whoever, if you take them on tour for too long and take them away from their equipment and deprive them of the option of like actually expressing themselves, they actually end up getting physically sick, stressed out. You know, it is a lifeline to these people to actually be able to express themselves.
So basically
musically.
What we're saying is most of the artists on Warp need therapy.
Why would you
want to
film it?
Yeah, I mean, you just listen to it. It's pretty much like this. There's not very much to see.
I reckon we're just going to release a live film, actually. I reckon we will. We should do one. We should do a film of us working with no sound on it.
Either that or an infrared camera. That's all people need to figure out. I mean, lights are just really, really toss most of the time. So gestural and
I don't know, they're usually really ineffective as well.
We don't get anything to look at, really. I mean, we're not really doing anything that looks particularly good. That's not why we're doing it. We're doing it because we like the sound of it, you know.
So, like, 12 blackout is the nearest thing to wearing headphones or whatever, you know?